Good morning from our beautiful little quail huts, as well as our new brooder area that we have outside. And there are little ducklings. They're actually not quite 3 weeks old, super, super close. But I'm just doing chores this morning, and I thought you guys might like to see what we have going on here. These little ducklings, and I'll wait till they come out to their pool. They were just swimming when I walked in. They're called white layers. They're going to be prolific egg layers, just like my golden 300. So we can expect 300 eggs per duck per year when they're fully mature. And ducks actually take quite a while before they start laying, right about 7 months. So we won't see eggs from these girls until next spring, late winter or spring. But the cool thing is they're starting to lose their duckling downy. And you can see little pin feathers coming in on their chest. These girls all started out with pink webbing feet and pink bills, and they're just now starting to orange up, which is another sign of maturity, which is super cool. They've been swimming since they were about 2 days old, and they're in their pool most of the day. And so I'll put some dried worms in there. They should come out for that, but let me show you my quail. They're all doing so, so well. These ladies here are my older quail. They range in age from 4 years to a year and a half. And this one right here, let me see. This one, she has a white feather on her left side. She waits for me every morning. She's so super friendly, and sometimes she'll actually scream when she sees me coming. So what they're waiting for really is their dried grubs. And so let me get that in there and I'll show you. Hi ladies. Hello. Hi mama. Hello. What's going on? What is that? What is that? Yeah. What is that? Let's get back this way. There you go. And here they all come. Let me spread it out for them. Hi guys. These ladies are so chill and so awesome. I actually have two males in here. One is my 4-year-old Schofield Silver, and one is one of my new white pharaohs. And they're absolutely lovely, and the ladies love them, and they're not a problem. We have about, I think, 49 quail in here. Let me get to the other side of the rain really quick. Hi ladies, how are ya? And we put grass clippings in here. If I weed, I'll pull out the big dandelions and put them in here, and they like to eat the worms off the roots and the bugs and some of the leaves and the dirt. Oh, there go my ducklings right now. They're going out to their pool. We'll go out there in just a sec. Hi ladies, hello. Hello, good morning. And I love coming out here and just visiting with them. They're all doing so well, so super healthy. And this one right here, she is one of my 4-year-old Schofield Silver. She's absolutely chill and calm and lovely. And she's kind of had a gimp leg for about the last year and a half. But she still gets around, and she is my girl who would love to be broody and sit on eggs forever. And so when she's sitting on eggs, I just leave her alone and let her do her thing. And I'm gonna get these guys' food in just a second. They like in the morning, and I always latch that when I come in and out so we don't have air. They like their bananas. Each hut goes through about 2 bananas a day, plus vegetable matter from our garden. They get their organic feed, and then of course the dried grubs. Let's get some dried grubs for my little princess ducklings. Hi guys! So they'll scatter when I throw the worms. And I love my new little vestibule here because I can stand out here and not get wet. Okay guys, are you ready? Here we go. Okay. They love this. Hi, guys. Hello. And we refill this pool about 2 to 3 times a day. And we'll put clovers in there. They love eating clover. They love dandelions. We put a lot of plant matter in there, and they absolutely love it. And ducks love rain, so they'll be outside almost all day. And they have nice tall grass to mess around with inside. But I leave the vestibule door open because we do have hawks and owls, and we've had some that have gotten just a little bit too close for my comfort. And so I need a place where they can come into and not be bait for the predators. Hi, ladies. We've been calling these guys our quacklings, our ducklets, our ladies in waiting. They're going to be absolutely beautiful. I've never had, well, actually, I had an all-white duck, Gertie, when I was about 5 or 6 years old, and I haven't had an all-white duck since, so this is going to be super, super fun. They'll move over to the main duck shack when they have all their flight feathers and can actually defend themselves. And they'll just stay in there all day long and just paddle around. Okay, let's get to quail hut number 2. So quail hut number 2, these girls are all under a year, and I also have some brand new quail in here from my hatching back in April. So I've got some that are right about 5 weeks old. So this is my younger hut. These guys are producing a phenomenal amount of eggs for being so young. But they're a little flightier. The older they get, the calmer they get. And so with this group, I have to be really super slow moving because they startle super easily. Hi, guys. Hello. Hello. Let's see what we have for you. Let's see what we have for you, huh? Hi, ladies. Hello. Hello. And I can't wear my raincoat out here. You know how raincoats make that certain kind of noise when you move? That really startles these guys. So I just have to wear a regular coat when I'm out here with them. Hi, guys. Hello. Throw some over there for ya. And these guys devour dandelions. They love dandelions. And we use our grass clippings to create kind of cover over the logs. So, because quail are ground birds, they like to get under things. So we create little cubbies and nests. Grass clippings are awesome for quail. They love when spring and summer come around. There's just way more vegetation we can offer them. And then our side panels on quail hut number 2 are actually just hardware screen. There's no greenhouse paneling. And so it's lots of fresh air. Sometimes the rain comes in. It's super nice. I like this one. The ceiling's a little higher, so I don't get a bruised head as often. I know, this is exciting. This is exciting. Let's get you some more. And I'll show you my 5-week-old quail. They're just now getting some beautiful feathering. They should start laying eggs in the next... Oh, there's one right there. That's one of my 5-week-old quail. Hi, Mama. Hello. And these guys like to hang out in here. I've got 2 of my year-old quail who have actually been very maternal with them, which is super cool. But they kind of hang back here where it's a little more nesty. Let's see. There they are. Hi, Mama. Hold up. Those 2 right there are my 5-week-old quail. And the one on the right is a male. You can see his rosy chest. And so I'm going to let him stay in here. He'll be the only male in quail hut number 2. And see, this is making the girls a little bit nervous. By next year, these guys will be way calmer. Super, super calm. Okay, let me go get you guys' food. Get y'all fed. So I just have to move really slow when leaving that area. So it's super interesting just to see maturity and how it affects behavior. Hi, ladies. Okay. Come out here. And then this little brooder, you can barely see it underneath this bag. This is where my quail that just hatched in my office will move to probably tomorrow or on Monday. I usually move them out when they're close to a week old. Has the nice heat lamp. Everything in here has greenhouse screening, so there's no direct wind, which is super nice. The ducks can retreat under here if they want to warm up, and they've got a nice little brooder lamp in there, a nice little heat lamp. And we put pine shavings in there, and I change those out about every 3 days and just put them in our compost pile, so it works out great. So we also get fertilizer. It's a lot of cleaning. Nursery season is a lot of cleaning and a lot of work, but for me the benefits are just so awesome, and I love taking care of brand new life, so it's kind of cool. And this has been an extra bonus. So this is insulation lining for one of my raw dog food boxes, and we use this just to keep the heat down at night inside the brooder area for the ducks, and it's been really super awesome. I think it saved a lot of warmth for them, especially on the nights where it got down into the low 20s. Oh, look at you, big kids. Look at you, big kids. You're out in the rain and everything. They just love it out there. You guys are flapping your little wings and everything. Let me get down low for these guys. And the whole vestibule inside here has the hardware mesh. You can see it in the camera. And so this is another layer of predator protection when we have this outside door shut. So our quail and our ducklings are doubly protected. Hi, guys. Hello. And these are all hens, so all these girls would be really good egg layers. You can see a lot of their white coming on with their new pin feathers. They're starting to lose their yellow, and their white's now coming on. And this is super cute. I don't want to move too much. When they get in the pool and they start dipping and cleaning. Okay, on to more chores.